Welcome back, guys. In the last lecture, we have discussed about how to add the local styling to React.js components. Now, in this video, we are going to discuss about dynamic styling in React.js. Means, how can we manipulate the CSS in React.js? So, first, I will show the demo. Afterwards, we will write the code. So, here you can see this is the demo. Here we have a text with the name "This is React Dynamic CSS." So, after clicking this button, this text color should change to some other color. So, initially the text color is black. So, after clicking this button, it should change to some other color. So, now I will click this button. Here you can see the text is changed to, the button is clicked and the text color is changed to brown from black. Initially the color is black. If you refresh here, initially the text color is black. After clicking, the both text is changing and the text color is changing. Now, in this video, we are going to implement this feature. So, let's open Visual Studio Code. So, to achieve this, we have to use the class components, because dynamic CSS can be applied with the help of state management only. So we cannot create the states in functional components. That's why we need to create a special class component. So here I will create a new class components in src folder. So I will create a new file with the name cc. So every time we are using the cc for class components only. So first I will create the class component. I will write the import statement, import React and component, it must be in curly braces, component from React. Now we need to create the class cc extends React.component. So this React.component class is having one method which is called as render method. In this render method, we have to return the HTML content. So before returning the HTML content, I will change the snippets from JavaScript to React. So it will give the HTML snippets in the VS Code. So here I will return the div. So I forgot to add return statement. Return div. In this, I will write the H1 tag. This is dynamic CSS. Now we have created the class component. Now we need to export it. Export default CC. Control S. Now we have to add the CC in app.js component. Import CC from, in the single colons you have to enter the file name CC. So after importing, you have to add the CC component in the demo, means this div. So less than symbol followed by the component name slash followed by the greater than symbol. Now let's see whether the class component is added or not. Here you can see we have to execute it in the localhost 3000. You can see the output. This is dynamic CSS. As of now, there is no styling for this text, because this text is from class component. We have not added any styling for the class component. So this above text is from the app.css component. We have added the styling in the local style sheet for this in app.css. If you observe the app.css, we have added the styling using the class names. So now we are going to add the dynamic styling for the cc.js component. So first we have to create the state in this cc.component. So before creating state, we have to create the constructor. Constructor. So in the constructor, we have to write the super method. So after the super method only, we have to create the state. So I will create the state with the help of this keyword, this dot state equal to. So state here is a object, that's why we need to write the curly braces. So in this curly braces, we have to write the variables in key value pairs. So suppose I want to add the two properties. The first property is color and the second property is background color. So first I will add the color. So after writing color, you have to write the single colons. In the single colons, you have to write the value. So here I want to write the value as red. So after color, I want to add the background color. bg color. So this is the variable name. Here I will write the value as yellow background color. Now we have to add these two variables in the style property of this h1 text. So I will show you how to add it. So first we have to create the inline styling for this h1 text style. Afterwards we have to use the equal to operator. After equal to, we have to use two curly braces. Whenever you want to add inline styling for the HTML elements in React, you have to use the style equal to. In that equal to, you have to use the two curly braces. So after two curly braces, you have to write the property and value. So first I will write the color property. Color. So here I will add the color as this color, state color. So here we have declared a variable with the name red. Value is red and the variable name is color. So I will add the color only. Color. That's it. So now let's see the output, whether the red color is added to the H1 text or not. I'll enter Ctrl S. So here you can see we got an error. Color is not defined. So this is because here we forgot to add the this.state before the color. So whenever you want to add the state variables, you have to use the this.state before the variable name. So that's why it is raising error, color is not defined. Now we have to use this.state.color. So I will enter Ctrl S. Now let's see the output, whether the red color is added to the text or not. I will open Google Chrome. Here you can see the color is added successfully. So before the execution, the H1 text color is black. So here we have added the color using the state property. So now the color is changed to red color. So here the statement states that the color property is received from the state. So here this.state.color value is red. So that's why red color is assigned to the H1. So now we will add one more color, background color. So I will add the property background color colons. So now I have to add the background color as yellow. So I will use this property bg color. This dot state dot bg color. Now let's see whether the background color is added to yellow or not. Here you can see the background color is changed to yellow. So before the background color is white, after we are adding the background color to yellow, it's changed to yellow. Now we have to create one button, and after clicking that button, we have to manipulate these CSS colors. So let's create a button in the HTML. So here I will create a button. So I will name this button as change color, and I will create one more button, change background color. Let's see the output. Here you can see we got two buttons. The first one is change color and the second one is background color. So after clicking this change color button, the text color should change to some other color like blue. So after clicking the background, change background color, the text color, the background color should change to some other color like pink or violet, etc. So now let's see the output. So now we have to write the code for functions. So first I will create the onClick for this button. OnClick. So here I will create the method with the name change color. This dot change color. This dot change color. So as of now we have not created this method. Afterwards we will create it. First we will initialize these methods. OnClick equal to this dot change bg color, means change background color. Now we have to create these two methods in this area. So here I will create the two methods. So the first method is change color method. So I will write the arrow functions, because the normal traditional JavaScript functions cannot be supported in the class components. We have to use the arrow functions. So I will write the change color equal to parenthesis followed by the arrow. In this we have to write the function definition. So after clicking this definition, we have to change the state of this color from red to green. So I will write the set state method. Set state method is used to manipulate the states in the class components. So I will write the set state. So this set state method accepts object as a parameter. So I will take one object. In this, first we have to write the property name. Here the property name is color. Afterwards we have to write the colon. So after colon you have to write the new value for this color. So I want to change the color from red color to green color. So I will write green. Now let's see the output. So after clicking this change color, the red color should change to green color. So I will click this button. Here you can see the text color is changed from red color to green color. So like this way we can manipulate CSS in class components. Now we will change the background color on button click. So I will create the onClick function. So here the onClick function name is changeBGColor. So I will write the function name as changeBGColor. changeBGColor equal to parenthesis followed by the arrow. Afterwards you have to write the function definition. In this also we have to write the same method, setState. This dot setState. In this we have to write the object. So the key is property name. Here the property name is bgColor. So bgColor. So I want to change the background color from yellow to, I will change it to brown. Now let's save it. Now let's go back to the Google Chrome. Now we will check both color and background color. Here you can see initially the background color is yellow and the text color is red. So after clicking the change color button, the text color should change to green. After clicking the change background color button, the background color should change from yellow to brown. So first I will change the text color by clicking this change color button. So I will click it. Here you can see the text color is changed to green from red color. Now I will click the change background color button. Here you can see the background color is changed from yellow color to brown color. So like this way we can create the CSS using the dynamic state properties and we can manipulate in class components. Thank you.